गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, रिस्पेक्टेड जूरी मेंबर्स. माय नेम इज वंदना प्रसाद फ्रॉम गलगोटियाज यूनिवर्सिटी, एंड टुडे आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग माय ई पोस्टर ऑन द टॉपिक द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ नैनो मटेरियल इन फॉरेंसिक फिंगरप्रिंटिंग. एज वी ऑल नो द क्राइम इज इंक्रीजिंग डे बाय डे, एंड टू हैंडल द सिचुएशन वी नीड अ की एविडेंस एंड एज वेल एज अ एडवांस टेक्निक. सो नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. हाँ, सो द फिंगरप्रिंट्स प्ले अ इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल, इम्पॉर्टेंट की एविडेंस रोल, बिकॉज इट इज अ यूनिक आइडेंटिटी ऑफ अ पर्सन एंड इट डिफर पर्सन टू पर्सन, एंड दे मे बी लेटेंट, प्लेटेंट और प्लास्टिक इन नेचर. लेटेंट फिंगरप्रिंट्स आर दोज विच आर इनविजिबल टू आर नेकेड आइज, पेटेंट फिंगरप्रिंट्स आर दोज विच आर विजिबल टू आर नेकेड आइज, एंड प्लास्टिक फिंगरप्रिंट्स आर दोज विच हैविंग अ थ्री डायमेंशनल स्ट्रक्चर. And out of these fingerprints, latent fingerprints are found abundantly because they are not visible and they remain undetected. So next slide, please. So there are many techniques used for the detection of latent fingerprints. There are some such techniques are iodine fuming, ninhydrin, silver nitrate, cyanoacrylate. Are being used for the development of latent finger in present time, but these techniques have some limitation when we comes to prints which are aged and because of the environmental factor. And these techniques, the conventional techniques, are failed to develop them. Next slide, please. So to overcome such a limitation, from past few years, nano scientists has been using nanoparticles for the detection of latent fingerprints. As you can see on this slide, the nano scale, as we can talk about the human hair, having a size about 100 micrometer, which is equal to five times more than a 1 nanometer. So as we go down towards our DNA, DNA is having 1 nanometer in size. And so as we get the idea that 1 nanometer is equal to our DNA, so the nanometer is that much small. So next slide, please. So nanotechnology is being used because it has shown a great potential in producing the next generation of fingerprint development technique, which is known as nowadays nano fingerprinting. The method offers the opportunity to develop new fingerprint techniques with superior property, including enhanced selectivity, improved contrast with background, and increased sensitivity. Next slide, please. There are some examples of nanoparticles which are being used for the development of latent fingerprints, like gold nanoparticles. From the literature survey, it was found that 2.5 nanometer of nanoparticle, average gold nanoparticles, was used for the development of latent fingerprint. And the most important thing of nanomaterial is that it interact with the fingerprint components. And so that they remain intact for about a course of time. So here, the gold nanoparticle generally interact with the fingerprint components by electrostatic force of attraction between a negatively charged gold nanoparticle and positively charged fingerprint residue. Second, silver nanoparticles has shown the development of latent fingerprint on porous surface, and it is also showing electrostatic force of attraction between positively charged fingerprint residue and negatively charged silver nanoparticles. Third, and these nanoparticles also use in the oxide forms or metal oxide forms, such as zinc oxide nanoparticle. They can be used in the nanopowder form. And by using zinc oxide nanopowder, it has shown a good fingerprint development on porous surface by a hydrophobic interaction. Next slide, please. So there are also different types of nanoparticles are there. They are used for the development of latent fingerprint by encasing with them with a functional group, some kind of functional group. So in case of silicon dioxide, it has encased with the carboxylic group. Carboxylic group is a negatively charged, and then it interacts with the fingerprint component like amines group, and they form amide linkage for the development of latent fingerprint by electrostatic force of attraction. So The fifth one is cadmium telluride, or it is encased with silicon dioxide. As we all know, cadmium telluride is toxic to environment as well as for mammals. So it is when it is encased with silicon dioxide, it forms a non-toxic nanopowder, and it develops a fingerprint with a fluorescence effect. So it having a electrostatic force of attraction between fingerprint residue and the nanopowder. Next slide, please. And the whole conclusion of the study is that the characteristics could be obtained applying different nanoparticles such as gold, silver, zinc oxide, etc. Therefore, nanomaterials play a vital role in the development of fingerprints and aids the investigator in solving the cases successfully. Thank you.